Hi, video pals, r/video pals, Reddit people. I can't even see. There's no point in doing that. I took off my glasses because I feel like they're distracting because they're broken. They've got tape on them, and I don't really like wearing them so much. And you probably see this. I got punched last week trying to stop a fight. You learn lessons the hard way sometimes. So my name is Will, and I came across r/video pals through random one day. I was just going through random subreddits, and I found it, and it seemed like a cool place, so I thought I would join your guys' community. Okay, the glasses are going on because this is just not working. The glass is broken, an unrelated incident. I was late for work one day, and as I was bending down to tie my shoes, they slipped off my face and split in two. And now they've got tape on them. Okay. Anyway, my name is Will. I said that. Right now, I guess technically I'm homeless. Like, obviously I'm in a house, which is my friend's, and I'm sleeping on the couch, but I just moved back to the States from Japan. I was living there for like 3 years teaching English to Japanese people. I wasn't teaching Japanese. So now I'm in America, and I don't really know where I'm going to live or what I'm going to do. I might go with my cousin to Australia for a couple of months to pick apples this winter, and beyond that, I have no idea what I'm doing. If you have any suggestions, I would love to hear them, because it'd be cool to have some sort of direction in life. So I guess I finally found, who is this? I'm gonna butcher this person's screen name, Stargoes Lobby. Anyways, they put together all the questions, so I'm just gonna pick a couple of random ones and answer those. So, what would you attempt if you knew you could not fail? I would try some sort of sporting thing, like being in the Olympics. I would totally want to do gymnastics in the Olympics if I knew I couldn't fail. I'm like 30 now, so I kind of feel like that's a little too old to start trying to do gymnastics, but I did it for a little while when I was a kid, and I stopped because I had this crazy Turkish instructor who scared me, and I had glasses and was like kind of wimpy. And when we started doing the uneven bars, which that's a woman's event, is the uneven bars, but the men's just had the single bar, but we were practicing on the uneven bars, and they wanted us to do like a flip from one to the other, and I was like, fuck it, I'm out, because that was just way too much for me at that young age. What are some nicknames you have? There we go, we can answer that one. So I have, every time I meet like new people, they feel the need to give me a nickname. So I've got, my brother was the first person to give me a nickname. He called me Jody when I was a kid. And then when I was in high school, I got called Pontiac, not after the car, after the Indian chief, Broby. Then in college it was Brooklyn. Because I had a t-shirt that said Brooklyn on it that I wore for like 3 days straight, and so a bunch of people just started calling me Brooklyn. And then I've got Will Cambo, which, if you know my name, then that kind of tells you a bit about that. What? I feel like I have more. And then just like a billion variations on my name, like Billy, Willie, Wilbur. My friend calls me Billy the Gunslinger. So a bunch of nicknames. My username is a derivation of one of my nicknames. So, like I said, in high school, my name was Pontiac, which got shortened to Pons, Ponz. And then whenever I go online, Pontiac and Pons are usually taken. So I started going by Pawnzz, because that's never taken. Go figure. Except by me. All right. So that was two questions by Topher and Stargo. Who's the most influential person in your life? I'd have to say probably Link from Legend of Zelda, like, because I didn't really have like a father figure growing up, and I didn't really have a whole lot of interaction with adults who were like sober. And so, I played a lot of video games as a kid, and so I love Zelda, and I love adventure games. So like, or not, well, adventure and like role playing games. So the character archetypes from those kinds of stories, I think, had a lot of influence on me growing up. But the problem was, is being like a kid who really believed in a very strong sort of like fantasy life, and then interacting with people who didn't, I think was really difficult for me for a long time. And I think kind of in my college years and in my 20s, a lot of that kind of died off, and I'm trying to find that again. But yeah, so I would say a person who really influenced me would be Link. Tattoos, that's mustache. I'm not doing really good with this whole keeping track of whose questions I'm answering. Anyways, it says tattoos. No tattoos. I wanted a tattoo for so long, and I've come so close to getting one so many times. I've got 3 designs that I really love, but I just haven't quite gotten the oomph to go and get it. I'm terrified of like getting it and then regretting it the next day. Like when I got my ears pierced, I instantly was like, oh my god, what did you do? And then the next day and the next day and the next day, like I progressively liked it more and more, and now I love it. I love having my ears pierced. Like I can't, it bothers me when I take out my earrings and I don't have anything in. What is an interesting place you've been? When I was in Japan, I went to this James Bond museum. There's a little tiny island kind of in south central Japan called Kagoshima, and it's like the artist island. And there's some crazy rich dude on that island who's got a weird fascination with James Bond. And he got like the city council to try and petition Universal or whoever owns James Bond to make a James Bond film there. And as part of that, they set up this museum and they filmed like a short James Bond film, but they couldn't actually use the name James Bond. So the guy's name is JB, which is really funny. And it's a ridiculous film. And if you go to this museum on Kagoshima Island, which is kind of funny because Shima means island, so it's like saying Kago Island Island. Anyways, if you go there, then you'll see this museum, and it's awesome because you can tell so much love went into making it, but it's ridiculous and hilarious. And it's so like, you can tell like the people, it's like such a naive thing to think that this tiny island would ever be involved in like a James Bond film. Like obviously like the, you know, multi hundreds of million of dollar projects, like they're not going to go to some tiny island in the middle of nowhere that has nothing really on it to film a movie. Like it was just silly, but they believed, they had this dream, and they put together this museum, and it's free to go to. So if you ever go to Japan, I sort of recommend going there. That's all I'm going to do right now. So hi everybody. Hope to become more of a part of the community here, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.